Good morning. Hey, how did God's people get into this mess in the first place? Our reading today is at Jeremiah chapter 50, chapter 50, verses 6 to 10. My people have been lost sheep. Their shepherds have led them astray. They have turned them away on the mountains. They have gone from mountain to hill. They have forgotten their resting place. All who found them have devoured them, and their adversaries said, "We have not offended, because they have sinned against the Lord, the habitation of justice, the Lord, the hope of their fathers. Move from the midst of Babylon, go out of the land of the Chaldeans, and be like the rams before the flocks. For behold, I will raise and cause to come up against Babylon an assembly of great nations from the north country, and they shall array themselves against her. From there she shall be captured. Their arrows shall be like those of an expert warrior. None shall return in vain, and Chaldea shall become plunder. All who plunder her shall be satisfied, says the Lord." So how did God's people get into this mess in the first place? Well, according to God, through his prophet Jeremiah, their shepherds got them into this mess. Their shepherds led them astray. They led them astray on the mountains. So here are God's people busy traveling from place to place. They're not doing God's will. They're not fulfilling his purpose for them. Instead, they're exploring. They're going over here. They're going over there. They're following out these wonderful big ideas that are being spun for them by the thought leaders, the people who they allow to be their thought leaders. And often those people aren't doing God's will. They're busy with their own little fantasy castle. They're doing their own big thing. They're following their own agenda. And God's people need to be careful which agenda they're following. Are they going to follow God's plan or the plan of some people who are very agreeable to be leaders? Now, let's be clear about another thing. You can't blame everything on the leaders. In fact, without followers, the leaders aren't going to do anything. There won't be anything that will happen following their plan. So leaders need followers. And so a lot of times we can really look at the followers, the people who are so willingly follow along the wrong leadership, and those are the people that really get the nation into trouble. Without the followers, the leaders would be nothing. A self-serving leader leads where the people want to go. A God-serving leader leads the people where they need to go. Now, it's true that the leaders in Jeremiah's time weren't elected by ballots, but still, there was a limit to how far they would allow themselves to be led. So the ball, so to speak, is in the people's court. Even an apostate leader can only lead God's people into as much apostasy as the people are willing to endure. Think about that. God's people who went into captivity, first they forsook their identity. They lost their identity. They forgot who they were. They forgot who they were supposed to be. They forgot God's purposes and they invented new purposes. And we can be sure that the new directions were carefully thought out and very rationally justified. Sounded like it made perfect sense. And step by step, the new directions were sort of taken and the people began to follow in the wrong pathway. And as they adopted those new directions, they left their maker and he couldn't protect them. So they left their maker behind and they progressed, if you will, in their mind, they certainly thought it was progression, and left behind the old faith and new modeled it until they went so far from him that it was impossible for him to continue to protect them. He would be denying his own truth if he continued to protect them. So exploiters came and plundered God's people. And Jeremiah here has these people justifying their actions by saying, well, look, of course we did this, because look, these people sinned against their God. They left themselves without protection. But the problem was Babylon went way too far. They went way beyond the chastening God planned for his people to receive. And now God is going to totally destroy Babylon, of course, as well. Babylon, as all nations that are not in submission to God, Babylon went too far. And now God's going to address Babylon. That's what we see here in this really interesting beginning of this series of prophecies. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, we want to be right in our hearts. We want to be right in our actions. And as the Psalms tell us, Lord, we ask you to search our ways, search our hearts, see if there be any wicked way in us, and then lead us in the way everlasting. Help us not to go the way that Judah, the kingdom of Judah, went and have to go into this situation of long-standing captivity. Oh, please, Lord. This is our prayer, Lord, today. We ask for it in Jesus' name. Amen. So, how did God's people get into this mess in the first place? They abandoned God's purposes for them. Never forget God's purpose for you, his people. God be with you in this day.